Happy gun opener, everybody. It's like four, a little after four. Got here real early. Just sitting in the truck. First got here though, so getting into some public today. Yeah. I'll be completely honest, my expectations, I'm unsure of what to expect, but I'm actually gonna hope to slip in really early and use any pressure from possible private land surrounding to hopefully benefit me and push some deer. So we will see what happens. If it's brown, it's down for me. I'd like to shoot a doe right away. So hopefully we're pulling out a deer or two on the compass cart. Should be fun.
Saddle here. Better get the gun ready. Not fully sure what to expect today. Oh, there's a deer cruising. He's pretty far. I'm just gonna see if it's a buck or a doe. Chilly. Well, it's been a pretty slow morning. Figured I'd take this as an opportunity to show the XOP saddle and edge platform that I'm sitting on today. First time ever gun hunting out of a saddle, and minus the fact that I, you know, haven't had much action, it's working really well. What's nice about this tree is I had all these branches, so I was able to climb up without needing any sticks, which just saves a lot of weight packing in. When I put the platform down there, got the tree tethered here, and as you can see, I feel really versatile with the ability to move around. Light. I spent a lot of time just practicing every different shot angle. What's nice is this tree splits right here, kind of forks out, which allows me to kind of put my feet on different parts of this tree. As you can kind of see there, it just gives me a lot of ability to move around. So, yeah, you need to use this kind of as a rest. what I think I'm going to do is slip up into the woods more. There's a hang-on stand that I'm going to put a hang-on up there. And what I can do, this has a built-in safety harness, so it's the saddle, but I can also use it for the harness. Must be tangled a little bit right now. I think it's behind a strap, but I'll get this and be able to... I just heard something. Sit at least a little bit later, but then I'm gonna make that move. It's probably the highlight of having the saddle is the ability to be versatile. Make a quick switch mid-morning. This is another advantage of setting this in kind of a notch of a tree. I'm taking the weight off of the saddle right now. I'm just leaning against this tree. Saddle hunting, multiple positions kind of help not get too like tired. Takes pressure off different parts of your body. I'm eating last year's buck for good luck. As you can see, I'm using the saddle now just as a tree harness, overlooking some thicker stuff. A couple nice trails in this spot. Shoot that doe anyway. It looked like it might have been a yearling fawn. But of course, right when I'm eating the snack and getting talking to the GoPro, all of a sudden it runs up on me. And the reason it came in so quick, and I just saw there's an Amish hunter walking around, and he must have bumped that deer. Because I saw him like a minute after I saw that deer, so I don't know if I really would want to shoot that anyway. That would have been kind of embarrassing if I popped a little fawn. It was young doe. That actually would have been kind of funny if that Amish dude just pushed that deer to me and I blasted it. Just had that same dude walk through. So, it's time for me to get out of here.
Buck down, baby. Buck down.
That was just... to shoot a deer, but when you do, like, there's a weird part of it where it's sometimes feels that. I'm not sure. I feel like a true conservationist, and like hunter knows what I mean. It's just a respect thing. I don't know. But no, I'm pumped, and I'm so glad I passed a doe. I had a doe like 40 yards, and I wanted to shoot, get some venison, and it was this early, and I'm glad I passed her. Stay sitting in that buck. Did it perfect. 40-yard shot. I could not bat at her. Not 40. He was at like 15 yards. I couldn't pass that up. There's another shot. I've just been sitting here for like an hour since. I watched like 10 turkeys fly down from the roost across the ridge. The squirrels are loud as heck. Man, I'm just blessed to be able to pursue this passion. And I'm very grateful for my friends and family that share that same passion. Keep me motivated. This bow season was defeating for me. I hunted really, really hard. Had a lot of encounters with deer, some nice mature bucks too. So I was just getting burned out, you know, getting up at 3 a.m. on the weekends and hunting hard. So it's definitely a sigh of relief to be able to put the tag on this one and relax over the Thanksgiving break and not feel that pressure to go out and hunt and try to fill a tag. Let's go check this guy out. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Jeez, he's technically got 8 on his left side. 9, 10, 11. 12 pointer, if you can really call it that. Cool buck. I was a little disappointed. I hit him high to start. Dropped him in his tracks, but I spined him. I had to shoot another one at him. Ideal way to do it, but on the bright side of that, it caused him to drop instead of run down this draw, so maybe that's a good thing.
Rachel will hop in here with you. You can sit right there with her. Alright, got them inner loins. You know what that means. It's gonna be tasty. There's like I have some like little ones with that too. Wow. Oh yeah, John. Oh, Milo, that was not food. That was tongs, but you can go check it out anyway.